Hello everybody, welcome to the lecture series on the topic Markov chain. I just come up with my new lecture, that is on the stationary probability for the Markov chain. So how we find the stationary probability of the Markov chain, and this is lecture number 5th of the series. So first of all, I just explain you what is the meaning of the stationary probability, and the question arises is obvious. The question arises is why we need the stationary probability distribution. So what is the definition of the stationary distribution is, we look the probability vector Q in such a way that when you multiply with the transition probability matrix P, then it becomes the remain same. What is the meaning is that, say you have some probability distribution matrix or called as the TPM. If you multiply with some vector that is called as the probability vector, then the resultant becomes the same probability vector. Then that is called as the stationary distribution. It is also known as the steady state or the limiting distribution of P. So it means it quite obvious that whenever you are talking about this limit n approaches infinity P raised power n, so that is a whenever you find the P square, P cube and longer power, it becomes say capital Q. So that capital Q becomes called as the steady state probability distribution. And one important point is that if it exists, then it always be a unique, because it's a probability vector. So the condition on the probability distribution is each of the QI is greater than or equal to 0 and sum of their Q is my 1. So the question arises, what is the physical significance of this stationary distribution? So in order to explain it, I consider the three different big markets which are available in our society called as the ABC. So this is my A, this is my B, C are there. So what is the meaning of it is a person, and the TPM is here. So what is the meaning of this 0.5? It means a person which are using the market A to purchase their products. In the next visit, he or she again use the same market A, the probability will be 50%. While 20% is that a person may switch switch from A to B during their shopping periods. Similarly, 30% is there. And at the market scenario, we can see that the market share at the present is 30%, 40%, and 30% is this ABC. Now what will happen is, I just calculate after a one time period, it means after a one visit, the market share will be here. Okay, after a 1 year, after 1 month, the market share will be here. So how you calculate that, this is nothing, this is my Q0, if you multiply them, it becomes here. So look at that, the market share of A is increases, while the market share of B is also increases, corresponding C is decreases after the 1 year. It means a person who is the owner of the market C will have to think here what strategy they have to follow. What about the after the 2 years? After the 2 years, look at that, the market share of the A is again increases, now B is decreases, C will increase them. It means here the market B will take care of them. After the 3rd year, the market scenario of the A again increases, B again decrease, here again increase, and so on. After the 7th period, or after the 7 year, look at that, now the market share of the A is decreases, here is increases, here is increases. And if you look at very carefully, that after the 3rd year, after the 2nd year, all the numbers are near to the 0.4. look at that, here is 0.4 and here is 0.2. and what about the after the 12th year, the market shares are remained same. It means if you calculate after the 13 years, the market remain the same. Okay, and so on. So this such type of the probability is called as the steady state probability, and our task is to find such type of the distribution is there. And look at that, all the distribution are approaches toward the stationary distribution of the A, while for the B and C is here. So how you compute them, that is the task. So I just explain it with the help of the several numerical examples. I just considered 5 different examples here to explain you. So consider a person whose last cola purchased by Coke, and there is a 90% chance that his next cola purchase will also be a Coke. So Coke, the 90% chance that next purchase he also purchase a Coke. Okay, And since that is a TPM, the sum of the row is 1. Okay, always remember that sum of the each row is 1. So the person who purchased last time Coke, in the next time he purchased Pepsi, the probability is the 10%. While if a person last cola purchase was Pepsi, this is the last purchase, the chance that his next cola purchase will also be the Pepsi will be 80%, and remaining is 20%. So you have to find that in the long run, what is the market share of such Coke and the Pepsi. If initially it was 55 and the 45. So the way of calculating is since there is a 2 cross 2 matrix, so we assume that there are probability distribution or called as discretionary distribution consisting of the two components, P1 and P2. Since it is a probability, so sum will be 1. Okay, and by the definition of the stationary will be, if you multiply this by this, it becomes the remaining same. So what we'll do is, now substitute Q is my P1, P2, capital P is here. Now if you multiply them, so what we'll do, this is first row, column. So what will happen is, 0.9 P1, 0.2 P2 is equal to P1. 0.1 P1, 0.8 P, sorry, it's my 0.8. It's my 0.8 P2 is equal to P2. Okay, now our task is to find P1 and P2. Since there is a 3 equation, you can solve any 2 equations because it's a, there is need of the P1 and P2. So if you solve the first and 2, so I can firstly remove like this way. So it is my 0.8, so it will be my 0.2. So if you solve the first and second, the answer will always be a P1, P2, 0. Always remember that whenever you are trying to solve the first and 2, answer will always be a 0, 0, but it does not satisfy this. So in order to make it simplify, always remember that you need a 2 equation in this particular problem. One equation must be of this. One equation must be of this. So you need to solve one equation must be of this, and any you can use any one of them. Either you can use first or this second one. So I use the first and third. After solving, you will get this. Always remember, students, you can't solve the first 2 equations. If you solve the first 2 equation, answer will always be a 0. So what is the meaning? What is the P1 is? That is a comp. So in the this is a steady state probability. So what is the meaning is that after this is a 66.67 for the Coke, Pepsi will be 30% of the market share if initially it was 55 and 45. So this is a way to calculate the stationary probability. Look at that, one more example is there. So there are the 3 different brands of the lipstick A, B and C. If you remember the last 4 lectures, lecture 1, 2, 3, I have discussed this problem again and again. So what is that? You have to again find the market share of these A, B and C. So what is that? There is a TPM. So since you can read the statement and draw the TPM very carefully. Okay, so there is no need for repeat again the statement. You can pause the video, read the statement, then write this TPM. And this is the initial probability for the A, B and C. Now since it is a 3 cross 3, so you need a 3 P1, P2, P3, such that sum is 1. Now after this, you can substitute the value of the Q and P here. So what will happen? The first equation will be my 0.7 P1, 0.5 P2, 0.6 P3 is equal to P1. Second is my 242, that is 242, third and fourth is there. So if you simplify them, this P1 is on the left hand side, it will be minus 0.3 and so on. So you can solve these 3 equations, these 4 equations, and you need the P1, P2, P3, you can solve any 3 equation. Make sure that you have this equation must be while solving is there. So it means you can solve either, this is equation number 1, 2, this is 3, say this is 4. So 4 must be there, so you can solve either 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 1, 3, 4 and so on. So I have to solve 1, 2, 4. The answer will always remain same. If you solve instead of this, if you solve 1, 3 and 4, the answer will remain the same. So what is the meaning is that the market share of the brand A is 63.889 while others are. Similarly, for the example number 3rd, say boys are there, again this is discussed in the last examples are there, and this is the TPM. You have to find the limiting probability, that is the steady state probabilities of the boys. So it is a 3 cross 3, so you need a 3 P1, P2, P3. After substituting here, you get this equations, and after that minus P1 and so on. So these 4 equations are there, you need to solve any three, make sure that the last one must be there while solving. So I've solved this, the probability becomes here. So the limiting probability is that 20% is for the boys A, 40 and 40 for the B and C. Look at for the example number 4, a professor try not too late for a class too often. If he is late on the one day, L is represent for my late. If he is late on the one day, 90% is sure that he is on the time on the next day. O is my on time. So there is a 90% chance that he is on the time. So it means the remaining 10% will be on the late. Similarly, if he is on the late on the time, the next time there is a 30% chances of his being late. There is a 30% chances of his being late. So you have to find how in the long run, how often he is late for the class. So it means you have to find the probability for the first. You have to find the probability of the P1. So since there is a 2 cross 2 matrix, so you need a P1 and P2. After solving this, simplify, you will get this. So since you are finding the probability for the late, so late is my first one, that is a P1. So there is a 25% chances that he will come late after the several years or several time period late. Look at the most important example is there. This is the most important application of the Markov chain. This is the application of the Markov chain. So look at that. Some hospital, ABC hospital operates on a charity basis. All the expenses are paid by the government. And the board of governors has been complaining about the size of the budgets and insisting that hospital cut their expenses. So what are the major area for them is for the ICU. And the cost of them rupees 1000 per week per person as compared to the rupees 500 for the wards are there. So this is the scenario there. After that, this, what is the past history recorded? This is the same continuous statement that a patient in the ICU at the beginning of the week, 50% will remain there at the end of the week, while 50% will move to the wards. And similarly for that, you can read the statement after pausing the video. After looking at this, the board of governor believe that the criteria for keeping the patient in ICU are too strict. So they have instructed the ICU staff to relax the criteria. So that the instead of the 50%, there is a 40% of the people which are living in the ICU, which are in the ICU patient, remain in the ICU instead of 50%, so that the cost will be less, and transferred 60 to the another wards, and then so on. So you can read the statement. So this is the actual scenario. This is the proposal given by the board of governor. So what is that? Will the policy adopted by the board of governor actually save the money or not? Means the proposal which are given by this will actually save the money or not. So look at this statement. Nothing is mentioned about the Markov chain. Nothing is mentioned about the steady state. So how do you understand that this part is for related to the Markov chain? So look at that. Will the policy adopted? So when the policy will be adopted? Is the policy adopted only for the 3 months? Will the policy adopted only for the 4 months? No, the policy will always be adopted for the long run period. Okay, so if the policy will be adopted based on this board of governor suggestion, so it means it will be adopted for the 7 years, it may be adopted for the 10 years. Okay, so it means this is for the long run. So it means long run means it is the steady state probability. So this is the way to have to check that this is a steady state probability. So what is the statement suggest that there are the 3 states, that is the ICU, wards and the outpatients are there. You can read the statement very carefully. And the cost of the ICU is given to be 1000, cost of the ward is given to be 500, outpatient cost is not being given. Before the board of governor policy, this is a statement given to you. Based on the board of governor policy, this is the statement given to you. So what, when the policy will adopt it, we can calculate the cost of this method. We can calculate the total cost based on this board of governor policy. So if the cost of this board of governor policy is less than of this, then definitely the policy will be adopted, otherwise not. So it means this is the cost of the 1000, this is the cost 1000 of the ICU. So we have to find the probability of the ICU. How many persons are there? Because remember that this is the cost of, this is the cost per week per person. So how you calculate that? We have to find their steady state probability. So what is that? This is the statement before the board of governors. So look at this statement. I have to convert the TPC, TPM, sorry, transition probability matrix. this is the I is absent for the ICU. Look at that. 50% will remain at the end of the week in the ICU. 50% will there in the ICU. 50% will move to the ward. 50 ICU to the ward. So it means the sum will be 1, so nothing is there, outpatient. On the other hand, on the patient of the ward, so if the patient in the ward at the beginning, 50% will remain there at the end of the week. So 50% will remain there. While 10% get worse and transfer to the ICU. So the 10% will transfer to the ICU. So the remaining well will be outpatient and so on. And based on this TPM, you have to calculate the steady state probability. Again, by using this rule, you will get this. Okay, so P1 is represent for the probability for the ICU, then ward, and then for the out. And the cost will be, this is the probability, cost for the 1000 for the ICU, 500 for the patient, for the ward. There is no cost for the outpatient, so it will be the zero. So the total cost will be rupees, it's not a rupees, so it's a 233.85 units are there. And based on the Board of Governor policy, so this is there, what is that? Only the 40% of the ICU patient remain in the ICU. So this is the patient. 60% are transferred to the ward. So the sum will be 1 and so on. And there is no change in the outpatient. So outpatient remain the same. So look at that. What is outpatient is? 5% is 10 and 85. There is no change in there. Now again calculate the outpatient. Calculate the steady state probabilities here. So look at that. The cost will be 285.65. And what is before the Board of Governor proposal is 233. So since the expected cost of the Board of Governor proposal is higher, so the proposal of the BOG will not save the money. So this is the way to solve this type of the steady state problem. So this is a very small lecture. You can easily understand based on a simple calculation. You can use the calculator. You can use a program to solve it. Next lecture will be on the classification of the states of the Markov chain. That is also so important. Stay tuned with it. Understand the lecture deeply. Be practice. Be safe. Best of luck, students.